World's best cities to live in have been revealed, with Vienna taking home the coveted number one ranking. Melbourne, which has previously held the top title, came in second, closely followed by rival city Sydney. Other Aussie capitals to make up the top 20 included Adelaide, Perth and Brisbane. Let's bring in social researcher Mark McCrindle now. Mark, thanks for being in the studio again with the latest. Let me ask you this. This report is by the Economist Intelligence Unit. It was released today. How do they determine the most livable city?
Well, they analyse 140 global cities across 30 different measures in five key categories of education, healthcare, infrastructure, environment and livability. Yeah. So that's what comprises. They give each city a score out of 100 and thus the list.
We're doing okay in terms of Australian cities, Melbourne sitting at number two. How did Sydney manage to jump from fifth to third place?
It did pretty well. It's only 0.3 of a point behind Melbourne, which has won this particular list seven times this decade. Mainly, the authors said Sydney has done well on safety and environment. In fact, it's a win overall for Australia because we've got Melbourne, Sydney and Adelaide in the top 10 and Perth and Brisbane in the top 20. So we're ranking very well.
Pretty close there between Melbourne and Sydney. There's some good rivalry there for the future indicator next year, perhaps.
Yeah, exactly. You know, just a smidge between them and Sydney being on the rise.
Let me ask you, you've said environment a few times there. It's the first year the report included the effects of climate change. How significant is that and how do they do that?
Yeah, it is. It's one of those 30 measures that they have brought in, and really it shows in the report that a city's ability to adjust sustainably is important. And that's why if you look at the list, the larger global megacities did not rank very well. In fact, Sydney and Melbourne, apart from Tokyo, are the largest cities in the top 10. It's those smaller cities that tend to be more adaptable and so thrive on a list like this.
So that's a badge of honour for the Australian cities that have made the high rankings here, that we're doing okay in terms of sustainability. Is that right?
Exactly, and the ability to adjust and adapt to these changing situations.
Interesting. So why didn't iconic cities such as London and New York make the top list?
Partly it is their size, and they didn't rank very well at all. London at 48, New York at 58 on the list. Cities of 8 to 9 million people, a lot of complexity, safety issues, stability issues, infrastructure issues. So that all marked those particular cities down.
It's nice to be judged like this, but I wonder whether some people sitting in, particularly Melbourne and Sydney, are saying whether or not their cities are really livable when they're dealing with congestion and increasing costs.
Well, true, Michael, and it doesn't look at affordability, it doesn't look at congestion. Right. So there are a few, you know, issues in it, but hey, you know, nice rankings there and we're performing pretty well.
Good to be the envy of the world. Mark, thanks for coming in.
Thanks.